And from the top.
Oh boy. It's gonna be one of those episodes.
That might be, but that's okay because it's a blooper one. Good day, everybody, and welcome to our second TGN blooper episode.
And here on The Good News, each week we aim to celebrate all things you. And you can view our past 41 episodes on the Youth Group's YouTube channel. This week, you sent us in good news stories faster than I can mess up my lines.
Oh, but you didn't do the, hey, why didn't the meteorologist go home?
Oh, man!
And thank you for the fabulous reply and heartfelt stories that came in.
And so, ladies and gentlemen, without further ado, I am Jacqueline Patterson Schaefer.
And I am Julia Sheffield.
And this is The Good News.
But first, a word from The Good News. Today's Bible verse is from Nehemiah chapter 9, verse 17. They refused to obey and were not mindful of the wonders that you performed among them. But they stiffened their neck and appointed a leader to return to their slavery in Egypt. But you are a God ready to forgive, gracious and merciful, slow to anger and abounding in steadfast love, and did not forsake them.
Nice one, Julia. Believe it or not, but some are turning to TGN for the very first time. And if there's one thing that TGN excels at, it is our professional take on the news. Oh, and if anyone gets a message from me about canned meat, I wouldn't open it. It's spam. I love it when you start laughing before you even get the joke. The First Presbyterian Dancing Society had their first Zoom meeting this past week.
That's oh, yeah. Line.
That's your line. That's not my line. We here at TGN pride ourselves on the high value of news that we bring to you each and every week. Did you see that? Oh, no, this is the next one. What? Okay.
What's the matter?
I'm just laughing at myself. See, when they record?
One time I didn't. One time.
I know.
Last Sunday, we talked about God being able to do the impossible. We learned how knowing that God can do impossible things can help us have confidence and trust that God is working in our lives when things seem hard. Tuesday's Bible study was our last one before we break for summer. We looked at the book of Jeremiah, and we talked about God's response to humans turning away from him, being filled with anguish, and how even in the heavy words of Jeremiah, there is hope for humanity as promised through Jesus. We're looking for volunteers for VBC. We need adults to commit to leading a group of 10 children through their daily activities from August 3rd to August 6th. We also have a few activities that we are looking for adults to help prepare for two different Vacation Bible Camp sites. If you're not able to help during the week of Vacation Bible Camp, but do have some time to spend preparing a 40-minute VBC site, then this could be a great way for you to participate this year. Please email me if you would be able to help with either of those opportunities or want to find out more.
And now it's time for our weather report, and I'd like to send it over to our meteorologist, Edward Pritchard, who joins us somewhat live.
Well, as you can hear and see, it's pretty good. Thunder sounds very much like it's supposed to. Clouds are looking very much like clouds, and the rain is, well, feels like rain. So I'd say it's good. Rain's even kind of warm.
Thank you, Edward.
And now for our favorite segment of our newscast, where we find out what's the good news in your life.
Alita McNabb has begun. What is so hiding about that?
Okay.
Maisie Ann Morris Milligan had... Okay, I should have read that first. The Aphelene Markle family enjoyed a delicious... I was so close.
So close.
So close. Wait, Julia, we forgot to celebrate the June birthdays last week.
Right. Well, we certainly do want to wish all the children and youth who celebrated their birthday in June a very happy birthday. Happy birthday to Evan Draper, Tessa Cheek, Madison Salcedo, Ryland Rowling, Macy Morrison, Alita McNabb, Freddie Wright, and Olivia Denny.
Happy birthday, guys!
You know, that is a pretty good news segment, too. And now, to hear the good news from the kids.
Noah Sheffield loves to build things and really wants a dog. So, he has been gathering sticks and clay mud from the river and built a dog house in his backyard. So he is ready if his parents ever decide. I mean ever. Noah, it seems like it's been a really long time, dude. If they ever decide to get a dog. Good luck, Noah. And what a dog house that is. Emma Sheffield loves art and loves to draw. Her teacher this year encouraged her so much. Emma drew this picture of a tiger one Saturday as a way to practice shading. Wow, Emma, that is a beautiful drawing. Ruth Ann has continued taking piano lessons and practices a lot at home. We can just tell by listening to her play. Here's an example of one of the pieces that she has learned recently. Job, Ruth Ann. That was beautiful. Alita and her mom had a great picnic outdoors together on a sunny day. It is so great to be able to take time and enjoy each other and the beautiful outdoors. That's great, Alita. You guys look so happy to be together outside.
Wow, that's great, guys. What does a tailor say when he makes a mistake?
Ooh. I don't know.
So?
True.
What is it called when a dentist makes a mistake?
Uh-oh. Expensive.
Yeah. But accidental.
Ooh, accidental. I like that.
Jacqueline, did you know that sisters can really know how to hold a grudge?
Ooh, I don't have a sister.
Well, my sister asked me to pass her a lip balm, and by mistake, I gave her a tube of super glue. It's been a month now, and she's still not speaking to me. I also made a mistake at the grocery store. I went to get 6 Sprites, accidentally picked 7 up. The point is that we've all made mistakes. I made a left turn once. It wasn't right.
Good one, Julia. Julia, if that's true, if it's true that from each mistake you make, that you learn something, then I must be Albert Einstein.
And now it's time for Did You Know? Hey, Jacqueline, did you know that everyone makes mistakes?
Yeah.
Did you also know that God knows that we're not perfect all the time and he loves us anyway?
He's pretty awesome that way.
The Bible tells us that if we really love God, we will try our very best to obey his commandments. These are the things that he asks us to do to make our world full of love and justice. Remember, Jesus said the greatest commandment was to love one another and to love others as we love ourselves. But that can be tricky to do all the time and get it right. And sometimes we mess up. When we do make a mistake, Jesus taught us to ask God for forgiveness. And in the Bible, it says that God will give us grace. Grace is loving and forgiving us even when we mess up, make a mistake, or don't follow his commandments. So when we make mistakes, we can remember that we're not alone. Everyone makes mistakes, and God forgives us every single time and keeps on loving us through everything. And I think that's good news, don't you?
I do. I think that's pretty awesome, Julia. Well, time sure flies when you're having fun. And as we wrap up our show, we would like to end with a smile. And thus we cut to our final story featuring us. Where does Veronica get these dog names from? That's all I want to know. They are impossible to pronounce. I love her though.
Oh, I forgot the last line.
Okay.
Oh, well, it doesn't matter.
And thank you for the heartfelt. Oh, that's you.
Oh, yeah. That's good, because I was like, no, he already fell for it. Oh, wait, that's you.
And that, oh no, that's not my line. That's not my line. That's not my line. Okay.
What kind of bow can't be a knot? Oh no, that's not it at all. Hold on.
Take two.
To listen with understanding and empathy. But
I am so sorry.
That's okay.
I'm sorry.
I forgive you.
Okay, thank you. Thanks, Julia. We here at TGN are, oh no, we already did that one. Yeah. Then I've got a meme.
I don't have a meteorologist.
Okay, color. Cover. Ah!
That's going in the bloopers row. Well, that was something. That's it for this week's episode of The Good News. And don't forget the best news. God loves you, and we do too.
For those of you that missed our first blooper episode or would like to watch it again, it was episode 28. And as long as Veronica doesn't get any more dogs, I'm sure that we will almost, well, hardly ever have any more bloopers of me pronouncing names. Well, it is somewhat more likely anyways. And finally, just a friendly reminder, if you're on YouTube, to hit that subscribe button at the bottom of your screen and the bell to be notified each time we release a new video. Or you can follow the Children and Youth Facebook page to be notified each time we release a new video. Or you can watch us on Instagram TV. And before you go, parents and kids, big or small, don't forget to send us in your good news through the week. We want to celebrate you in our next episode. And that concludes this episode of TGN. See you next week.